Go is a statically typed server-side language that is great for low latency and is built with concurrency in mind. In this video, we'll demonstrate how straightforward it is to create your first WebSocket in Go. If you're not familiar with WebSockets, they establish a two-way connection between a client and a server, much like a phone call once it's connected. This is great for real-time applications where updates or messages need to be exchanged without repeatedly fetching data. Let's jump into the code and write your first Go WebSocket that communicates with the real-time data server. For this tutorial, we'll be using Gorilla WebSocket library, which we will install using the go get command. Start with creating an empty directory in Go and make a .go file. At the top, write package main to create an entry point for the standalone executable. Import the necessary libraries, including Gorilla WebSocket library. Now let's declare the main function, which will be the entry point from where your program starts executing. Within your main function, we'll declare channels. Channels are similar to pipes through which information flows. In Go, these are used to send and receive data between concurrent functions called Go routines. Message out channel we declare will only accept string variables. Interrupt will carry values of type os.signal. The one part specifies the size of the buffer is limited to one value. In Go, it is customary to employ signal.notify function to register a channel for receiving system signals, such as Ctrl+C to terminate the program. Next, we'll declare the u variable of type url.url and initialize it with struct literal, which takes in scheme, host, and path. Struct literal just means creating and initializing the struct in a single line of code. Struct is very similar to a map or a dictionary in JavaScript and Python. Before we move ahead, don't forget to subscribe and like our content. Now use the dial method in WebSocket default dialer provided by the Gorilla WebSocket package, which takes in two arguments. The first one is obvious. The second one is to add HTTP headers. As we are not passing any, we will leave it nil. The dial method returns three values: C for connection, response for HTTP response, which includes status code, and error for potential errors. Afterward, we check for errors regardless of the outcome. We use the defer c.close function to exit the connection when the surrounding function returns. Defer function works in reverse, so first defer statement executes the last. We create a third channel named done, capable of sending and receiving structs, and define a new Go function that handles messages. Within the Go function, we start a while loop and use the readMessage function in WebSocket connection C to collect incoming messages. Underscore is used to discard the message type. The WebSocket we're connecting to returns connected message and expects a user key and symbol to commence data reception. We verify whether the received message is connected and then send the required user key and symbol string to the message out channel using the pointing arrow. The arrow direction signifies that we are passing our string into the channel. We'll see how this works shortly. The program now enters the main loop. Inside the loop is a select statement. This statement patiently awaits events from various channels, including done, message out, and interrupt. When a message becomes available in message out, it is received and assigned to M. For the message out case, when we receive a connected message, we send it using c.writeMessage. This allows us to transmit messages while asynchronous loop continues to receive them. To run the code, you can use the go build command to create an executable, or simply opt for go run. You can see the real-time data streaming via WebSocket connection. Now for a little trick. You can use the log set flags command, which will get rid of the timestamp, which can be annoying sometimes. Maybe it's just me. Apologies if it wasn't such a great trick. We trust that this tutorial has been informative. Please consider subscribing and liking our content, and remember to click the bell icon for updates. Thank you for watching.